and will say, come here. Come here, Gunner. Come here. Oh my gosh, you're such a good boy.
Gunner is a freedom dog in training and bringing a smile back to the face of Ian Welsh. Before working with Gunner and the other freedom dogs, the 25-year-old Marine did not go out in public much. Captain Catherine Harrington remembers meeting Sergeant Welsh for the first time.
Because he was just so withdrawn and just kind of coping with some of the awful things some of these guys have to deal with.
In 2003, Sergeant Welsh left Iraq with a traumatic brain injury. He later deployed back to war a couple more times. He survived attacks that left his buddies dead.
You know, I lost 12 Marines in 3 years. There's people who have lost 12 Marines in one day. And so I count myself lucky.
But Sergeant Welsh is struggling. Every day he battles with post-traumatic stress disorder.
It was quite confusing for me because I don't know what's going on. All I know is that I'm forgetting things.
The Freedom Dogs, like Charlie, help Sergeant Welsh when he misplaces an item, like his keys. Charlie is also there to distract Sergeant Welsh when something like a loud noise triggers his PTSD.
You know, I'm not diving underneath the table yelling grenade. However, I might be thinking about that.
Charlie's there to ground Sergeant Welsh.
Charlie makes his presence known, and when he's lying down, he puts his head on my boot.
If Sergeant Welsh is nervous, tense, or distracted, Charlie knows. Charlie's undergone 2 years of specialized training to be a therapy dog for someone with a cognitive disorder.
Yeah, see, there's the chin he has to touch.
Charlie's owner and trainer, Beth Russell, helped start Freedom Dogs in 2004. In 2006, the Marine Corps agreed to start a pilot program with the service dogs to see how they can help troops with PTSD. Sergeant Welsh is one of the first success stories of the nonprofit.
He is so much more confident, but more than that, most of all, he smiles. He makes appointments. He hasn't missed anything.
Sergeant Welsh lights up when he plays with Gunner. He works weekly with the puppy in trainings, even drives an hour on the freeway, one of his PTSD triggers, just to take Gunner to vet appointments.
He's going through the training to be a service dog while I am going through my training to handle a service dog.
After a year of training, if Sergeant Welsh meets the requirements, he'll get to keep Gunner.
Tell me a secret. Yes, I know she's pretty.
Seeing the restored confidence in Sergeant Welsh is overwhelming and rewarding for Freedom Dog volunteers.
It's such a wonderful thing to see him be a person again.
While Sergeant Welsh may never fully escape the demons in his head, these dogs help this freedom fighter regain a sense of liberty one day at a time. For Zoo 2 Pet News, I'm Deanne Goodman.